Playground National Molson in Sampy, Quebec, including coverage of the first round of eliminations in pro stock, an update on qualifying results in Top Fuel, and a look at the Nitro Funny Car field from north of the border. It's a half hour of live drag racing coming up next on this edition of NHRA Today. At historic San Air Raceway east of Montreal, qualifying is now history. And what awaits the throng of French-Canadian faithful is the quickest contest in Quebec, the 22nd annual Le Grand National Molson. In the pits, the drivers await the bilingual call to action while the crews fine-tune their exotic machine. At stake in the coming hours, prize money, points, pride, and prestige at NHRA's annual 4A to the North. Welcome to this live edition of NHRA Today. Bonjour, everyone. I'm Steve Evans. In the next half hour, we will indeed bring you live coverage of the first round of pro stock competition. But first of all, let's find out what was hot from yesterday. And I mean hot with a capital H. Eddie Hill in his yellow car set an event track record at 5 seconds flat. But right at the finish line, the engine exploded. A piece of shrapnel took off a tire, and Eddie Hill was on a fiery three-wheel ride. Now, what was his first concern? The condition of the automobile? Not exactly. His own personal safety? Hey, let's remember who we're talking about here, Eddie Hill.
What do we turn?
5 flat, low elapsed time track record.
All right, that's what we needed. All right, I'd blow another tire for that.
The Texan definitely beats the drum of life to his own rhythm. Now, we have a very, well, complex broadcast schedule today. Let's go to Brock Yates for an overview.
Well, Steve, before we go to the first round of eliminations in Pro Stock, let's bring everybody up to date on the schedule for the rest of the day. Remember now, we'll be back at 2 o'clock Eastern for a half hour of updates and interviews, everything going on here that will lead in to our final show at 5:30 Eastern. Then we'll bring you the championship runs in Pro Stock, Funny Car, and of course, Top Fuel. Going to be a great day of racing. The weather's perfect. Everything looks really good. But right now, let's go to our pal Dave McClellan for an update in exactly what's going on in Pro Stock.
Brock, this blue and white Oldsmobile blistered the San Air quarter mile with a 719 at over 194 to hold the number one spot for Warren Johnson. You're just moments away from the start of eliminations. How do you get yourself ready?
Well, getting ready is an individualistic thing. You just have to be mentally ready for anything that's going to happen with the race car, with the racetrack, or whatever your opponent's going to try to throw at you.
7:19 yesterday. What kind of times today?
Well, it's possible to run teams this morning, but as the air heats up, the track warms up, I doubt if you'll see them this afternoon.
All right, Warren Johnson, number one qualifier. He's headed to eliminations in just a moment. Right now, let's go to Don Garlitz and find out the story in Top Fuel.
Thank you, Mac. I'm with the number one qualifier in Top Fuel, a blistering 495, new track record, and brand new car. How about that, Pat?
Yeah, it was great. We come up here with a new car, and we thought it was showing good potential, and the track held it, and we were able to run the first 4-second run up here in Canada, and it just feels great to be here for the first time and do that.
We wish you the best in the race. Okay, Bob Fry is with the number one qualifier in Funny Car.
Thanks, Big. And I'm standing in the pit area of the number one qualifier in the Funny Car category, Al Hoffman. Al, the blower drive service car is number one, but they had to go to a tiebreaker. It's the slimmest of margins to put you on top.
Well, we're pretty pleased to be here. We've been trying to get this number one spot. I believe this is the fifth time this year. Four times we've been number two. So we're pretty proud to be here. Tom Anderson's done an excellent job. The entire crew has really worked hard this weekend and starting to pay off.
This is indeed a very talented crew. Number one qualifier, the tiebreaker, the mile per hour that gave Al the number one spot. Let's go back with Steve Evans.
Let's go racing. NHRA Championship drag racing. The first pair in round one of Pro Stock already fired during the burnouts in the booth, Brock Yates.
Thank you, Steve. And we got a good one to start off the day with. That is Alvin Gauthier from right here in the Montreal area doing his burnout. Coming back is Larry Morgan. These two went together in Columbus just 2 weeks ago, and Alvin lost to Larry, who went on to finish runner-up in that event. Let's go down to Big Daddy for an update on what's going on the starting line.
Well, Alvin Gauthier has been running real good at this event, and Larry Morgan has been having a little bit of trouble getting down the racetrack. Now, he's faster than Gauthier, but if anything happens, it's going to be Gauthier's race. Steve?
Big Daddy, I sense a huge upset of the making here. Larry Morgan has not gotten down that far lane all weekend long. He's experienced what they call shake so violently that some of the drivers have been, well, woozy down here. Morgan, a little out of the groove. That could be enough for Aubin Gauthier. The French Canadian fans have gone mad, as has his crew. A 7:49 for Aubin Gauthier. I told you it was coming, Brock.
You're absolutely right, Steve. Unbelievable. The folks are loving it here as Aubin Gauthier, who has not gotten past the first round in over 3 years. In fact, it's been 2.5 years since he qualified at Memphis on our last live drag race. So Aubin, delighted. Okay, the next pair coming to the line, that will be Jim Yates in the near lane. And Frank Iaconio and Bob Price join me in the booth. I'll tell you, this is going to be a good one, Bob.
The Canadian fans certainly love that opening round in pro stock there as Jim Yates coming up now. Gauthier had never won a first round. Yates has not lost the first round this year. Big, what's it look like on the starting line?
Well, this is going to be a very, very even race. These two cars qualified within a hundredth of a second of each other. I predict that who leaves the line first will be the winner. Okay, Brock.
Okay, Big. Jim Yates. Frank Iaconio has had some problems in the last few years with a great runner in the early 80s, Bob.
Iaconio went to the finals here three different times, but look at Yates. Smack him off the starting line. Big top end charge. Nope, Yates gets the win.
Yates, a winner at a 7:24 against a 7:67 for Iaconio. So, Jim Yates rolling down. Let's go to Steve.
Well, folks, we have to take a real quick break, but we have more pro stock racing coming up live. In fact, two of the best, Bob Glidden and Jerry Ekman. National Molson, the 22nd running is underway live. We've got pro stock on the pad. Here is Brock Yates and Bob Fry to call it for you.
Steve, and we got a pair to draw to. That is Bob Glidden, the winningest driver in NHRA history, going against Jerry Ekman. Now, we know Glidden's had some problems in the last season, but Ekman comes in here off a win at Columbus, and he has struggled, Bob Fry.
He really did. He struggled the two races right prior to that. First round out in Atlanta, second round out at Memphis. And, of course, Big, you're down there in the starting line, and you know what it's like to be a champion. What's it like to be a struggling champion?
Well, it's not all that easy, but I talked to Bob Glidden earlier this morning. They put a brand new clutch in this car for this run because they want to get Jerry Ekman. Now, if the track will hold it, watch out for Glidden. He could be bad. Steve?
Well, Ben, Jerry Ekman has got to be concerned. Bob Glidden is in what most people feel to be the better of the two lanes. He saw Larry Morgan and his Oldsmobile get out of the groove, upset by Aubin Gauthier. That has got to be weighing on Jerry Ekman's mind. He has the points lead. It's a significant one, but he'd like to extend it here if he can. The pre-stage light on that just helps the driver stage. They're both pre-stage, inching forward. Now exactly on the starting line, Buster Cousins has started. We'll flip the switch. A yellow, 4/10 of a second later, a green. Beautiful start. And it's Glidden that has control problems. Glidden has to shut off. He would have crossed the center line with disqualification. A 7:58 for Jerry Ekman. Well, I'll tell you, this is some first round, huh, guys?
It sure is, Steven. I'll tell you what, Ekman still struggles. 7:58 isn't going to win you much here today, Bob.
Absolutely. Ekman was there for the taking. Glidden had some problems. That was certainly a deficiency of the car and nothing to do with the racetrack. But there's a rematch that we saw in the semifinals at Pomona earlier this year, which is as far as Bob Glidden has gotten since that race. Glidden has not gotten past round number two.
He is really snake bit right now. Okay, let's go to the next pair. Ricky Smith and that STP Pontiac will go against the guy that's been running well, Mark Pollock.
Pollock and Smith met up in the finals down there in Houston. Smith was actually quicker off the starting line, got the win. He ran a 7:32. Pollock got the win, although Smith ran a 7:32 to that 7:28. Don, that shows you how very important that starting line advantage can be.
Let's go down to Big Daddy Don Garland.
Well, Smith definitely going to take a starting line advantage if Smith wants to do anything with Pollock. There's too much difference between these two pro stocks times. And you know, in this pro stock racing, even a hundredth of a second makes a lot of difference. And I certainly give Pollock the advantage, and he's got the lane. I think this lane on this side of the track is definitely performing better this morning. Brock?
Okay, let's go down to Steve for the race call.
Well, I agree with everything Big Daddy said. Performance-wise, you have to give the nod to Mark Cowan. But Ricky Smith is a more experienced driver, and driving is what it has taken so far today. We saw control problems in both lanes. Ricky Smith has driven not only drag racing cars, but circle track cars. He match races a lot on racetracks that a lot of guys wouldn't even go down. Not much better than plowed fields. So look for Ricky Smith to maybe have a pretty good chance in what might be an off lane. Mark Pollack, he's trying to forget Ricky Smith is there. He's just trying to run his own race, cut a good light, and race the clock, and hopefully run quick enough for lane choice in the next round so he can keep that near lane. Here is Ricky Smith, one of the finest drivers in all the drag. We got a little bit of a staging war going on. Buster Couch starting to get involved. They pre-staged, and neither driver wanted to move. He points at him, and they will not mess with him. They will move right in. Ricky Smith, he knows the trouble he can get into with Buster. Buster has a memory like an elephant. Ricky Smith, Mark Pollack, Smith at the eight. And did I call that? Ricky Smith at the far lane, and a nice elapsed time, too. A 7:27.
That's a great run for Smith. That is the 11th time in 14 rounds of victory that he's been first off the starting line. Smith really needs to win one of these things, Brock, and the STP Pontiac takes a giant step right there.
He sure did. He had great reaction time, too. That was an excellent run by Ricky Smith, who moves on. As we go down to the starting line, this man, Bruce Allen, he's won here a couple of times back in the 80s, Bob, but right now he and the rare Morrison team have been struggling a little bit.
They've gone out the last three races in the first round. This is a track where maybe they can right themselves. Guys have a different affinity to racing at certain tracks. Don Garlitz is on the starting line. Don, isn't it true that certain drivers like to race at certain tracks?
That certainly is a fact. They all have their favorites. I know I had mine. Indy was always a favorite track. And Allen has got his favorite lane here. So it's going to look like a real good chance for Allen to make some points. Brock?
Okay. Move into space. Good luck by both cars, but it's Allen against Ravesci, and he's moving out to a pairing of convincing victory.
That's what that team needs, a 7.49 for the losing time, but a great 7.24, over 191 miles an hour for Bruce Allen. And Brock, that's exactly what the doctor ordered for the rear and Morrison car.
No question. Good. Strong top speed, 191 miles an hour, so maybe rear and Morrison is back into it. Let's go to Steve.
You know, this crowd is about 50-50. French Canadians and folks from the north, northeast, out of Vermont, New Hampshire, Maine, and Massachusetts. For a lot of them, geographically, this is the only national event they can attend. So they keep abreast of the action in drag racing by being members of NHRA. You get 48 issues of National Dragster for just $48. Welcome back to our live coverage from Montreal, and a special welcome to those fine fans from Connecticut that took the time out to make that banner. Means a lot to us, and we'll keep them coming. Also, we'll keep the pro stock action coming live from Le Grand National Molson. Here again, Brock Yates.
Thanks, Steve. And the car you see backing up there is Scott Jeffrion's famed Wayne County Dodge. He qualified number three. He's going against John Noville, Bob Fry, who's new in this league and only qualified in 14th. This ought to be a walkaway for Jeffrion if everything worked properly.
Well, Noville's new, but the car is not. This is the same car that Warren Johnson rode to the number one qualifying position here, and the car that has all the power that anybody in this field's going to have. He's going to try to get that first win, but the starting line advantage is really going to be key here. He needs to get a great jump off the line.
Let's go down to Big Daddy.
Well, Scott Jeffrion looked up at the board and he saw two 7.24s, which just equaled his qualifying time, so he knows he can run good. Noble, on the other hand, has seen a couple of upsets, and that's what he's looking for. Steve?
Favorite part of the Mopar Dodge got Jeffrion is in his right here. The in-car camera, and you're on board. Remember, this is live. He's moving the levers on that five-speed transmission. He doesn't see Noville. Oh, boy, was that up right for the Dodge team, though. A 7.44. Noville gave him a lot more of a race than I think they expected. That was a honey.
Wow, 7.44 to a 7.45. He may not have seen him from that in-car camera, but I mean to tell you, he saw him out of the side of his eye, Brock.
No question. Jeffrion had to just drive hard to get that done. All right, that white Oldsmobile belongs to the Warren Johnson team. That is co-driver, team driver, Don Beverly, getting ready to go. And Beverly will face Gordy Rivera, who's a mighty tough competitor in pro stock.
Gordy's running out of Yuma, Arizona. There's 0.07 of a second between these two in qualifying. Beverly's already been to the finals twice so far this year. Would like to take that team car into the championship round. Big Beverly's got a great opportunity here in the first round to advance.
And Rivero is going to have to take it on a hole shot because there's 7 hundredths difference between these two cars, and that's like light years. So Beverly should have an easy win here unless there's some kind of an upset. Steve?
From what we've seen so far here in round one, I think just about anything can happen. Gordon Rivera out of Yuma, Arizona, is one of those guys that can get the hole shot. He's proven it before. If Don Beverly has any kind of a kink in his armor, maybe is his driving. So here's Rivera. I think you're absolutely right. He's trying to get that hole shot. It appears that he has. The lights are green on the tree. Gordy Rivera has stolen an enormous amount of time, and it works for him. Gordy Rivera upsets Warren Johnson with a 7:31 elapsed time. Not the greatest number, but I'm sure when the man in the other lane sees the review of this, he's going to say, man, I got to get one of those practice trees and work a little bit on my driving, because definitely late off the starting line was the Oldsmobile driver. Speaking of Oldsmobiles, here is the best, the quickest car of this event.
Absolutely. That is the man who has just dominated Pro Stock Racing so far this season, Warren Johnson. And he's took away the track record and low ET here at Santander so far, Bob.
Amazing that last run. That's the first round win for Gordy Rivera all year. Beverly has had two times this year where he's been stunned in the first round. Back in our last live show in Memphis, he lost to Lucinda McFarland in round number one. Vince Curia, former Supergas World Champion, WJ. Don Garlitz on the line. What do you think WJ's thinking now that he knows his team car's out?
Well, you know that's not good, Bob. He's got to be upset. So this is a chance for Corey. Steve?
Warren Johnson in the near lane, Corey in the far lane. 8,000 RPMs off the starting line. Corey is out of the groove just a bit. Warren Johnson, low elapsed time of the round at 7:22 in the AC Delco Oldsmobile. Johnson is the force to reckon with here today.
I'll tell you what, though, Vince Curry didn't give many slack.
Castrol presents the GTX Pipeline, the latest news from the world of drag racing.
Top fuel racing is so tight these days, drivers like Ed McCullough will do anything to get an advantage, including hiring a personal trainer. How's that work?
Well, Steve, if you're physical fit, you know, if you feel better about yourself, realistically, you should be mentally better off.
Better reaction time?
Well, I don't know if it's going to make me a better driver or not, but it's going to make us better. It's certainly not going to hurt me.
Hard work, though, isn't it?
Really hard work.
Let's meet Todd Stopp. He's that trainer that puts Ed through his paces. How many days a week in Indianapolis, Todd?
Ed's working out 6 days a week. He's doing a variety of different exercises. Monday and Thursdays, hitting a little chest and tries. Tuesdays and Fridays, a little back and buys, and Wednesdays and Saturdays, legs.
You measure body fat for progress. How's he doing?
Well, when he first started out about 2 months ago, I would estimate he was right at 30%. And now, 2 months later, we just had him tested yesterday, and he's at 22%. And, you know, changes like that, you know, don't happen regularly.
You'll see this man around a lot. Ed's taking him on the road to keep him going. Let's take a moment now to look ahead to the other pro categories, the Armor All Insiders Forecast.
Thank you, Steve. I'm in Don Prudhomme's pit, and he is the only other top fuel dragster to reach the 4 seconds here at Montreal. And he was only 1/100th of a second off the low ET of the event. Now, Don Prudhomme has been in the finals here more than anyone would like to remember, including last year. He's got a crackerjack team, and he's an excellent driver, and I expect he will be able to step up. So for now, more on the funny cars. Here's Bob Fry.
Thanks, Big. Earlier in the show, I was in the pit area of the number one qualifier in funny car, Al Hoffman. We mentioned that he was the top qualifier by the slimmest of margin. He ran the exact same elapsed time as Cruz Pedregon, the driver of the McDonald's car. The difference, the mile per hour that vaulted Al Hoffman to the top of the pack. Now, very rarely do we wind up seeing the number one and two cars meeting in the finals at a national event. But the way the cars are bracketed off, with Pedregon on one side and Hoffman on the other side, to me, it seems inevitable that it'll be the blower drive service car and the McDonald's car in the finals. Now for a look at Pro Stock, let's catch up with Dave McClellan.
Bob, it's kind of tough to pick them in Pro Stock, but my prediction will be the racer that wins this Grand National event is going to be the one that is best able to adapt to the conditions as they change throughout the day. Rest assured, it will not be the same in the second, third, and final rounds as they found here in round number one at Santander. Now let's go to Steve Evans.
Well, if you'd like to do some forecasting of your own, here's how they'll line up for the second round of Pro Stock. Remember, the quicker driver from round one will have the lane choice. And folks, unfortunately, we are out of time, but we'll be back at 2 o'clock with another live NHRA Today show from here in Montreal. And of course, back at 5:30 with a special American Sports Cavalcade, the Pro Finals, again live. For all of us here, Bob Pride, Big Daddy Don Garlitz, Brock Yates, I'm Steve Evans saying so long, and we'll see you back here again at 2 o'clock.
NHRA Today has been brought to you by Castrol GTX, engineered for today's smaller cars. Promotional